In this video, we will set up the route files required for our travel blog. So it teaches you how to create pages in a Next app. In case you missed the previous videos, we are using Next.js to build the front end of a headless WordPress backend. Next.js follows a file-based routing system, and all the route files go inside the pages directory. First of all, we want to replace this default index.js file, which represents our site's home page. So let's delete this file right away, then replace that with an empty index.js file. Then create a new file called index.js. From that file, we want to export a function component named home. Export default function home, which returns the layout in JSX format. For now, let's add an H1 heading tag that says, "Welcome to Cool Nomad Travel Blog." So, Cool Nomad is the name of our imaginary travel blog. To check if it's working, let me open the terminal and run the command npm run dev, which started the development server on port 3000. Then open the browser, then go to http localhost port 3000, and we can see the output. By the way, you can see some stripes on the page. It's caused by the default global.css file, which is loaded from the app.js file. We want to remove that. Delete this import statement, and now it's gone. So the home route is created. Next, let's move on to the blog section. We want our blog page to be inside a directory called /blog. So within the pages directory, create a new folder by the name blog. And inside that, we want to create two new files, one for the blog index page and the other for the single post pages. So create a new file called index.js within the blog directory. So whenever you have a subdirectory inside pages, adding an index.js file creates an index page for that path. Similar to what we did with the root index.js file. Okay, we want to export a function component from this file as well. Export default function. Let's name it as blog home. Return heading 1. This is our blog index page. Okay. Let's go to the browser to verify that. Localhost /blog. Okay, it's working. This is our blog index page. Later, we will replace all these placeholder texts with real code. Now we are just creating the routes. In addition to the blog index page, we want to display individual posts as well, right? For that, we want to create a dynamic route. The index.js files we have already created are examples of static routes. The point here is Next.js supports two types of routes, static and dynamic routes. But how are static and dynamic routes different from each other and when to use them? For instance, in our blog application, we may have hundreds or even thousands of blog posts. But it's not practical to create individual static route for each post, right? Instead, we can create a single dynamic route for all posts, which checks the URL parameter to render the right content. The route function component has access to this URL param and uses it to fetch the appropriate data from the backend API. During build time, Next.js goes through all the possible URL param values to generate all the posts. In order to create a dynamic route, put the route file name within square brackets. That's how it's different from a static route file. So here I'm gonna name it as post slug within square brackets followed by .js. Then export default function post. Return. For now, let's just give a placeholder text. This is a sample post. Now let's go to the browser. Since it's a dynamic route, I can put anything after /blog, for instance, sample post. And it shows this is a sample post. Change the URL to something else. and still we got the same output. Later we will use this slug part to fetch the appropriate data from the backend. I will also show you a way to supply the route with a list of all possible post slugs so that it takes care of posts that don't exist with a proper 404 error page. For now, let's go back to the code editor to create the remaining route files required for our application. Similar to the blog section, we also want to create a category section to display the blog posts from a particular category. Let's create a new folder called category. Again, we need to create a dynamic route for this as well. Because the content of the category archive depends on the URL parameter, that is the category name. So let's name the route file as categoryName.js in square brackets. Note that now we have two dynamic routes in our application, postSlug.js for the single post pages and the categoryName.js for the category archive pages. And if someone clicks a post title listed within the category archive page, it loads the corresponding single post page, which is rendered using the postSlug.js route file. Okay, let's create the remaining routes. One for the about page and the other for the contact page. The about page should start from the site root, that is domain/about. One way is to create a static route file called about.js. But instead, I'm gonna create a dynamic route, which we can reuse for any WordPress page, not just the about page. For instance, the site may have terms and conditions and privacy policy pages, which are all created as WordPress pages. I hope you are already aware that posts and pages are the two different content types in WordPress. We have already created one for the posts, and with this dynamic route, we can handle the pages as well. Let me name the route file as pageslug.js. Okay, next we want to create the contact page. The contact page could also be displayed using the pageslug dynamic route if it contained only static text content from the backend. But we need to create an HTML form in the contact page. So I think it's better we do that on the front end. So let's create a static route called contact.js. As usual, export default function contact, return contact us. I forgot to add the export statement in the page slug route also. Return, this is just a page. Okay, I hope that's enough for now. We have the index page, page slug, that is about, terms and conditions, etc. Then we have the contact page, blog index page, the single post page, and the category archive page. Okay. Export default function category archive, return category archive. Let's verify that in the browser. This is the home page. About, this is just a page. Suppose we had another page, privacy policy, that will also work using the same route. Then we have the contact page. Then we have the blog index page, single post page, blog/sample post, as well as the category archive page, which looks like category/cat1. All right, now that we have set up the routes, in the next video, we will design the home page.